Get Rich Slow with John Wolf. Hey, things are tough right now. I read that something like 3 to 3.8 million people have been laid off in the last couple of weeks. And I just want to talk really quickly about what you can and should do if you are among the people who are having your hours dramatically cut, if you're furloughed, or if you're laid off. Because I want you to be able to succeed financially and take care of your family as quickly as possible. So one of the first things I would say is absolutely be looking for a job to replace the one that you had, maybe even be looking for a better job, but in no cases should you stay unemployed. I'm not talking about any specific rules about getting a mortgage loan. But the way that you're viewed in all kinds of financial aspects and even your own self-worth and the way other people might perceive you, it for most people is connected to being productive. So one thing that you can do both to help the long-term financial outlook when you go to get a loan, but also just to make sure you're doing something, is start some kind of a business. I have no idea what you should do, but all that you have to do to claim that you were working on your business instead of saying that I was unemployed is you have to come up with an idea and a name, talk to an accountant, get it registered, do your taxes properly, and bam, you weren't unemployed. You could have had a totally break even, hopefully, or even slightly unprofitable business, but at least you weren't unemployed. And that's really important in very real ways. And hopefully it's a huge success, but saying something like, hey, I had a failed food truck is much better 2 years later when you're going for business financing, personal financing, or applying for a mortgage loan than saying like, yeah, I was unemployed. And I'm not saying you shouldn't claim any benefits you're entitled to. This is just an idea for something that you can do to make sure that you're at least putting on paper some kind of positive movement. You know, the last thing that I want to be able to explain to an underwriter when I'm looking at a loan file was that somebody was laid up not doing anything and it wasn't because they were sick. You know, I want to have a great excuse. Talking about credit and credit triage. So right now there are incredible programs. If you call your mortgage servicer, your auto loan servicer, utility bills, all sorts of people are allowing you to defer payments. Now, I want to make it very, very clear. I haven't really heard about any of these programmings giving you like a free money grant. They all expect you to pay them and pay them back with interest. But you know, in the case of mortgage loans, it's not going to show up in your credit whatsoever, and it's not going to incur any fees past the interest, which can be substantial. You know, a lot of people on their normal mortgages are paying like $1,200 a month in interest. So if you take 3 months off, you're going to be 3 months behind on principal payments. You're going to have that $3,600 extra interest stacked up now on your principal, and you're also going to owe money in your escrow accounts for taxes and insurance. So make sure you don't get caught flat-footed by all of that. But anyways, I really, really encourage anybody who doesn't know what they want to do or is caught out by this and is suddenly unemployed, go find something immediately, working for somebody, working yourself, but put it on paper that you're doing something. Because it is a job, the thresholds for mortgage lending, just so you guys know, and I'm going to talk about several programs kind of together, but there doesn't really need to be an explanation for a less than 1 month job gap. There has to be a significant explanation for a 3 month job gap. And for Govy loans, FHA, VA, if there is a 3 month gap, then in order to qualify for a new loan, I have to show sometime before that gap that you were able to successfully hold down a job for 2 years straight. Again, it's fine to have less than 1 month gaps in there. And then there are sort of more complicated thresholds for how long you have to be back to work. If there's a 3 month gap, it's not really a hard line, but they really like to see 1 year plus a paycheck kind of. And the gold standard is 2 years, but by no means has to be 2 years. And then for a conventional loan, what they're really looking for, depending on the exact circumstances, is 6 months. But it could be immediately if you have a good enough previous work history and you weren't away from long enough. So just to give an example, you know, you can actually, without much of an excuse for getting a government loan, have a job gap of 4 months and then have been on for the last 6 months. But before that, you know, you were working pretty solidly for the last 10 years. That works. But if the same thing happened and it wasn't a 9 month job gap or a 6 month, it was a 10 year. Well, what the writing actually says is, I'm forgetting the exact quote, but it's, you know, the reasonable chance of continuance of income based on your history. So they really want a longer time period of you working successfully, a shorter time period of you not working at all, and then a decent time period of you working again. That's why I'm trying to give people the advice to set up small businesses of their own if they can't find a good employer right now. But, you know, even if, you know, it's a big step down, but if you're able-bodied and can start working for one of the packaging service, I hear that Amazon and similar organizations that are delivering are just hiring immensely right now. It's much better to be doing something than nothing. Anyways, have an awesome day. If you have any questions, like, share, and subscribe. Peace.